बहुत खर्चा कर रही है पब्लिक, बहुत खर्चा कर रहा है वन प्लस ब्रांड. दे हैव रोप्ड इन रॉबर्ट डाउनी जूनियर एके ए आयरन मैन फॉर देयर ब्रांड न्यू ब्रांड कैंपेन फॉर द वन प्लस सेवन एंड द वन प्लस सेवन प्रो हैंडसेट्स. रिमेंबर ही इज नॉट अ ब्रांड एम्बेसडर बट दे आर एक्चुअली गोना डू एन एड कैंपेन विद हिम फॉर दीज न्यू फोन्स. नाउ यू माइट वंडर व्हाई रॉबर्ट डाउनी जूनियर, वी आर गोना गेट टू दैट. बट वन थिंग दैट्स ब्रेकिंग आवर नोटिफिकेशंस is the video that I did yesterday, jo a comparison hai between the OnePlus 7 Pro, the 12GB, 128GB version that I have right here with me, which costs about 58,000 rupees, that versus the Google Pixel 3a, which literally costs less than 40,000 rupees, that has only one camera, and this has three at the rear and one in the front, which actually pops up. Yeah, that's the biggest party trick, the popping camera, the popping selfie camera. But this got completely decimated and defeated by the Pixel 3a in my yesterday's comparison test and results. And a lot of you are like, hey, but it's so unfair. You're so biased, yaar. Why are you only talking about the camera? Well, I mean, if you want to compare photo results, you will talk about the camera. When it comes to performance, there's really no two ways that this is one of the greatest and fastest Android phones ever. In fact, you should go to Tech2's YouTube channel where I've done an in-depth video review, and on Tech2.com, you should go look at Anirudh's review. But a lot of people are in two different camps. There are people like me who are calling OnePlus out for putting a very mediocre, very average performing camera on their 58,000 rupee flagship phone, which also starts at 48,000. There's a whole range there. But others are like, bro, ऐसे कैसे बोल सकता है तू कैमरा अच्छा नहीं है? Because magazine covers shoot किए हैं OnePlus के. कौन से magazine covers? Take a look at this. National Geographic. This photo has been shot using the OnePlus 7 Pro. Sacred Games Season 2, Netflix का official communication. Ganesh Gaitonde on OnePlus 7 Pro. Rajkumar Rao on GQ का May का edition using the OnePlus 7 Pro. This guy is not Rajkumar Rao. He's Anirudh Regidi. He's reviewed the OnePlus 7 Pro in depth and he's taken over hundreds of pictures using this camera and is as disappointed as I am when it comes to the camera performance. So Anirudh, how is it possible that a phone like this is apparently shooting images like those and signing on Robert Downey Jr. as, you know, a branding person for their phones, but we struggle to get images that are locking focus, yeah, that, you know, can just reproduce basic normal colors, yeah, that we can see with the eye, but everything looks washed out and just, you know, overexposed on this. What is going on with the OnePlus 7 Pro camera? And also, I know I love talking, and also the DxO Mark score. 111 DxO Mark score is the highest for any smartphone, no, or okay, it's among the highest that OnePlus has ever scored.
It's the second or third highest phone. Okay.
I know, but it's nowhere comparable. No. So what's going on?
Honestly, if you ask me, I have no idea. Because like, if you see the National Geographic image,
yeah, it's a remarkable,
yeah, the
photo.
Sharpness in this image, I
the
could not replicate
range,
in any
sharpness.
Shot. Yeah. And like, we had issues where the white balance would change between images.
Exactly.
Using the same camera.
Exactly.
I couldn't focus on objects that were like close enough. It would say 0.5 meters to 1 meters. Never worked.
Let me show you this image I tried to shoot yesterday, right here. Okay. So that's me right here. What is going on here? There's no focus on the face. And I've been struggling to get focus. There's literally no focus here. And the same image on Pixel 3 was fantastic. A little low light and it refuses to focus Anurag's face altogether. I mean, yahan pe to kuch bhi nahi hai. And you expect autofocus to just work normally or properly, right? Look at this shot in portrait mode, the Hulk photo. It's softish focus almost everywhere. And I have no idea what's going on. So what about the DxO Mark thing? A lot of people are like, there's a different firmware for the camera. Help us, yeah, understand that.
So DxO Mark apparently got a beta firmware for their phone. The thing is, we don't know whether that was the actual firmware that we received for testing or whether they got a custom firmware that nobody else has access to.
So, but the point is that there could be a software update to, yeah, the OnePlus 7 Pro camera in the works.
In theory,
which is what DxO Mark got access to,
yeah,
which is why they were blown away by the camera while, yeah, we are consistently disappointed with it.
And plus, DxO Mark has a rating system where they give additional points for zoom cameras or wide-angle lenses.
Oh, so this has a 3x, yeah, optical, yeah, zoom and a wide-angle lens,
yeah,
so it gets extra marks.
Yeah, and the thing is, if you look at the ratings, the Pixel is at 100 and the OnePlus 7 Pro is at 111.
But the Pixel blows this out of the,
yes,
water every single time.
Every single time. maybe it can't shoot 3x zoom, but I mean, if it can't, the OnePlus can't take a normal photo, which is good.
Who are we supposed to trust? Because OnePlus is clearly using the DxO Mark score of 111 as a big marketing point, saying, hey guys, we are up there with the iPhones and, you know, everyone else.
Yeah. I have no idea, because even with these images, OnePlus told us that these are not digitally altered, but the photographer himself said that these are raw images, which means by definition they are digitally altered. So I have no idea what is going on here. Hopefully we reach out to OnePlus, hopefully they'll respond and explain what's happening.
Okay, another, you know, war cry of sorts out there on Twitter is people are like, hey, Gcam install kar, bro, Gcam install kar. Gcam, for the uninitiated, is the Google camera app, which is what you use on the Pixel phones, but is not officially legally available for download, neither on the Google Play Store nor anywhere else. I mean, it's not officially available to download and use on other phones. What is the scene with Gcam, and how does the performance dramatically improve using Gcam on simple phones like Asus Zenfone or Redmi Note 7 Pro and maybe the OnePlus 7 Pro?
So the thing is, when you get raw image data, right, that's just electronic signals that are coming to the phone. It's how you process it that determines what the final image looks like. That's why Canon and Nikon cameras, the images will look different. That's why a Pixel looks different from a Sony. In this case also, Google camera uses AI to determine what is the most pleasing image to us. It's not necessarily the most natural one, but maybe we prefer contrast, so the images are more contrasty, so we like them. And it's possible that maybe OnePlus just didn't have the research and development, like the budget to do the research that Google has done.
But they have the budget to sign up Robert Downey Jr. for a campaign. Yeah. Why is that a big important thing for them?
I have no idea. Maybe they want to target the US market or something.
The North American market, where they're not really as big as they are in India.
Yeah.
And hey, I mean, RDJ has a huge pull even here in India.
Of course. Avengers.
India is the second biggest country in terms of revenue for Avengers, the last one, Endgame, right? So what is the future now? Like, what's going to happen with the OnePlus 7 Pro camera and its updates? Because a lot of other reviewers are like, hey, our pictures don't look so bad.
Yeah.
Like, what's going on?
I honestly don't know. It's just the phone is really good, and it's only the camera that's the disappointing thing.
Only the camera is a big deal.
Yeah, I know. But the thing is, they're already there. You know, maybe the next iteration can really blow people, like blow people's mind, like with that amazing photography and whatever else they do with it.
Okay. Okay, interesting.
It's not there yet.
It's not there yet, definitely. You have to go to tech2.com where you should read Anirudh's detailed review of the OnePlus 7 Pro. And I completely agree with what he said. It's already a super brilliant phone. It looks mind-blowing. The display on this, the 90 hertz display, is unprecedented. The speakers are decent as well. Most of the things are great. And if you are a PUBG fan, then to play PUBG on this, on the highest setting, it's a must-buy experience. But the camera continues to disappoint. To me, it's a big, big, big thing, because for me, smartphones is equal to cameras in your pocket. And for a lot of customers as well. So we are actually going to compare this with the Redmi Note 7 Pro. That's right. The only common thing between them is the 7 Pro moniker. But this is what, a 20,000 rupee something phone, and that's a 58,000 rupee phone. We'll see which camera can actually lock focus and take decent pictures. Meanwhile, you must follow Tech2 wherever you're watching this video, and go to our YouTube channel and check out the detailed review of the OnePlus 7 Pro. Thanks for watching. This is Gadget.